Namashivaya student, today we are going to start our new chapter. This is chapter 9. Previously we have already done introduction from this chapter. Now we are going to start this chapter 9. This is Reoptics and Instrumentation and this is part 62. So we know that nature has endowed the human eye with the sensitivity to detect electromagnetic wave within a small range of an electromagnetic spectrum. So here electromagnetic radiation that belonging to the region of the spectrum, the wavelength is 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer, is called the light. So it is mainly through light and the sense of visions that we know that interpret the world around us. So there are two things that we have to mention about the light from our common experience. So it travels enormous speed and that is travel in a straight line. It looks something sometimes for people to release for people to realize that the speed of light is finite, and obviously this is measurable, which is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So speed of light in vacuum is the highest speed in nature. So the path is called the ray of the path through which it travels is called ray of light. A bundle of such rays continues a beam of light. So here refraction, the phenomena of refraction, reflection and dispersion of light using the ray picture of light, we can understand the reflection and refraction. Now reflection of light by spherical mirror. So we know that what is reflection, the angle of reflection between reflected ray and the normal, the reflecting surface of or equal to the angle of incidence. So this is the law of reflection, means angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So here we also know that incident ray, reflected ray and the normal. Another law is incident ray, reflected ray and the normal, and the point of incidence which lie in a same plane. So these laws are valid at each point on any reflecting surface, whether the plane is curved, plane, whether it is plane or curved. So we can say that the normal in every case that we have to take, the normal is the tangent to the surface at any point of incidence. So this is the normal. So that is, the normal is along the radius and line joining the center of curvature of a mirror to the point of incidence. So we can say that geometrically we can say that the center of a spherical mirror is called its pole, while that of the spherical lens is called the optical center. So this one, the line which is joining the pole and the center of curvature of the spherical mirror is known as the principal axis. And in the case of spherical lens, the principal axis is the line which is joining the optical center with its principal focus. With this principal focus. Now some sign convention. So we know that this is the relationship with the reflection by spherical mirrors and refraction by spherical lens. So there are different sign convention for that. So according to this convention, we can say that the distance of a measured distances are measured from the pole of the mirror of the optical center of the lens. So the distance which measured in the same direction as the incident light is taken to be positive, and those measured in the direction which is opposite to the direction incident light, which is taken, always negative. So this one is the incident light, which is positive and opposite to the direction, this is negative. So the that height which measured upward with respect to x axis and the normal is this principal axis, then this is positive, and obviously this one is downward which is negative. So we can see that the formula according to the formula of spherical lenses and also formula for the spherical mirror, for the sign convention this is different. So focal length of spherical mirror. So what is focal length? So we know that the parallel beam of light is incident on a concave mirror and the convex mirror. So the rays are biaxial. So The incident, they are incident at point which is close to the pole, which is P, and the mirror that takes small angle with the principal axis. The reflected ray which is converges at the point F of the principal axis of a concave mirror for a convex mirror. So here the F means that point, the reflected ray which is diverge at a point or converge at a point, which is called F, and this point is called focal, principal focus of a mirror. If the paraxial beam of light were incident and making some angle with the principal axis, the reflected ray would converge from a point in a plane and through A normal to the principal axis. This is called the focal plane of the mirror. This one is the focal plane of the mirror. So this one is A, which is a this one is A, this one is B, and this one is C. This is the focal plane. So the distance between the focus and the pole of a mirror is called the focal length of the mirror, which is denoted by F equals to R by 2, where R is the radius of curvature of a mirror and C is the center of curvature of a mirror, and the ray which is parallel to the principal axis striking the mirror, which is A. Then CM will be perpendicular with the mirror M, and theta is the angle of incidence. Here MD be the perpendicular from the M on the principal axis, or that this one, okay, or we can say that MCP, so that part which is equivalent to theta, and obviously MFP here, this one is 2 theta for this part. This is the geometric figure. So here we can say that tan theta equals to, obviously tan theta equals to what? This way, this is the height and this is the base. So MD by CD, and here for the tan 2 theta equals to, this is MD by obviously DF or FD. So theta is very, very small. So we can say that tan theta is proportional to theta, or tan 2 theta is proportional to 2 theta. So we can say that theta equals to MD by CD, or equivalent to 2. 2 MD by CD. So here this one MD and this part MD will be cancelled out. So FD equals to CD by 2. So here FD equals to what? FD equals to focus, this one. And what is the value of CD? Here CD equals to that R, which is radius of curvature. So F equals to R by 2. So this is the focal length. F is the focal length. And this is the radius of curvature. So this is all about today's topic. Tomorrow we are going to start another topic from this chapter. So till now, thank you, student, for watching this video.